Welcome to the OCI Grails Quickcast, bite-sized portions of Grails productivity tips to help maximize developer productivity with the framework. Grails Quickcasts are brought to you by OCI, the home of the core Grails development team and your source for professional support, project work, and training around the Grails framework. Grails Quickcasts are distributed in partnership with DZone, who help build knowledge and relationships to maximize your success.
I'm Iván López, and I'm a member of the Grails team at OCI. In today's Quickcast, I'm going to show you the different ways we have to debug Grails Core to fix issues, and also how to debug the Grails CLI. We've seen in another Quickcast how to debug Grails applications, so if you are interested in that, please go to guides.grails.org and take a look at this Quickcast about developing Grails 3 applications with IntelliJ, because here it explains everything you need to know about how to debug your application. Imagine that there is a bug in Grails and we want to try to fix it and submit a pull request. The first thing we need to do is start the application in debug mode. To do that, as we saw in this Quickcast, we need to click in this debug green button and then wait until the application starts in this debug mode. Another thing that we need to do is set a breakpoint in our code just to stop the execution here. So let's put here a breakpoint and wait a little bit until the application starts. Now that the application is up and running, what we can do is reload this page and try to find some artist. I'm going to try to find you too. And as we can see, the execution stopped here. So instead of continuing debugging our application, what I'm going to do is control click this render method, put here a breakpoint in this Grails code and continue the execution. Now we can debug Grails code, execute every line one after the other and try to find and fix the issue. The problem with this approach is that if we try to modify this file, we can't. File is not readable. So we need a way to be able to modify the source code. To do that, what we are going to do is going to GitHub, github.com/grails/grails-core, and we are going to clone Grails repo and configure it in IntelliJ. I've cloned the repository and imported it on IntelliJ, so you can see here all the different modules inside Grails Core. And before debugging Grails, we need to do a few things. The first thing that we need to do is change to this branch, 3.3.x, because we want to fix the issue in the latest version of Grails. The other thing that we need to do is compile everything and install it on our local Maven repository. To do that, we need to execute it, gradle w install. This can take quite a few time the first time because it will download all the dependencies, compile everything, generate all the jars, and install on your local Maven repository. For me, it only took a few seconds because I already did that. So what I've done here is install this version, Grails 3.3.3.build-snapshot, because it's not final yet. We need to go back to our original application and set this version as the default version. So this is our original application. We need to open gradle.properties file. And here, instead of using Grails 3.3.1, we are going to change this and set Grails 3.3.3 build snapshot. Once we save the file, we can see that Gradle here is reloading all the dependencies and that we just installed in our Maven local repository. We can also check this here if we go to external libraries, scroll down a little bit, and we check that all the Grails dependencies, all the modules, all the libraries are using this 3.3.3.build-snapshot version. Now that we are using our snapshot version, we are going to start the application, our original application, in debug mode. As we saw in Jeff's Quickcast, another way to do this is doing gradle w boot run dash debug JVM. This will start the application, and now, after a few seconds, it will wait listening on this port for a remote debugger. So instead of using this code, which is the original application, we are going to use a Grails core to debug our application. So what we need to do is going here, edit configurations, and we are going to create a new remote debugger. We can put here any name we want, Grails remote. We don't need to change any of these default options. We just accept and create this one. And now that we have selected Grails remote, we can start debugging the application. So now our IDE will connect to the application in this port, and the application will continue starting. So now it's starting. So what we are going to do is open the original file that we use here in this code. So if you remember, we were using response renderer in this line 216. So we go back to Grails core, open response renderer in this line of code, and if we put the breakpoint here, and here we try to find again for another artist. Now let's find Oasis. We can see that the breakpoint stopped here. So it's pretty much the same as we did before. We can continue debugging the application, but here what we can do is actually modifying the source code. So imagine that we want to see the content of this arc map. We can see on the debugger that it contains all the parameters sent to the view, to the render method. So we can do something like this. Print arc map. And we can even save the changes. But even if we have saved the changes, if we continue debugging the application, we can see that the code is not the same because we haven't reloaded all these changes, right? So what we are going to do now is compile these changes and apply them again into this application that we have been running here. So let's stop this and then go back here. And what we can do is execute again this Gradle install. But as we have only modified one module, we can only install that. So we can do here Grails plugin controllers : install. We need to stop this application. And here on the left side, we are generating a new version of this modified Grails source code and installing it on our local Maven repository. And now, once it finishes, we will be able to start here. Okay, it has finished. So here, we can start the application again. I'm not going to start it in debug mode. And now we will be able to see these changes here when we execute the code here on the console. So let's wait a little bit. Yeah, the application is up and running. So let's find again for U2. And we can see here the code that we add here into Grails code, okay? Of course, we can also start again the application in debug mode with this dash debug JVM option. We can also, once we have the application listening on 5005 port, we can connect here with the remote debugger. And once we do that and the application starts, we can also debug now these new changes in our Grails code. So let's find again Oasis. And as we can see now, we are able to debug. We can see that we have print the arc map, and it is printed here. So with this approach, we can modify Grails source code, we can test it in our own application, and we can try to fix any issue that we may have find. The last thing I want to show you here is that once you have finished the issue, the things you need to do is you need to create a new branch here on the repository. You need to add some tests. it's really important to test any new feature or any bug that you fix, and then you can submit a pull request to the Grails core repository. And it's also really important to execute this task, Gradle W test, because this will execute and run all the tests in Grails core. So you want to make sure that you don't break anything. This can take around 3-4 minutes to finish, and it will run, as I said, all the tests in Grails. Now, in this second part, I'm going to explain how to debug the Grails CLI. Imagine that the issue is in one of the Grails commands, for example, in Grails create app. We may try to do something like this, Grails create app foo dash dash debug JVM. But as we can see, this is not working because this flag is unrecognized. So what we need to do is define this Grails opts environment variable with this content, which means that we want to put the JVM in debug mode. So now, if we try to create a new application again, we can see that the command is waiting for the remote debugger. So we can go back now to our IDE. We can open Grails CLI, put here a new breakpoint. We can also open create app command, set here another breakpoint, and using the same Grails remote application that we used before, we can start the remote debugger to connect to this Grails create app command. So as we can see here, the execution stopped in this breakpoint, and here we can debug the execution of the Grails create app command. We can continue, and we are now debugging actually this command. We can finish, so the application has been created. And now if we want to undo these changes, what we need to do is unset this environment variable. So if we now execute Grails create app again, the JVM is not in debug mode anymore. So that's all. I really hope you learned something new today, and thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching this episode of the OCI Grails Quickcast. For more information on how OCI can help you with Grails or any of these other practice areas, visit ociweb.com or contact us at info@ociweb.com. Follow our Twitter accounts at Object Computing and at Grails Framework. Also, read regular updates on the OCI Grails team blog at grailsblog.ociweb.com.